Snowflakes. Finished all of these. Yeah, that was pretty quick. Well, not quick, but simple. Obviously, we want to quick sell those. We're not going to adjust our lineup today. We do have some players they could get rid of. Still don't know what I'm going to do with Kevin Green and Keyshawn Johnson. We need to pick four of these. Well, let's pick the wrong button. It's that button in hockey. Pick the four golds. One, two, three, and four. Unfortunately, I think we get Snowflakes sort of crushing that dude. I have to sit on. We're definitely gonna wait. It's like our kicker. Let's see. Go buy a card. Same card we already have. We go, Jesus, there's a 96 Derrick Henry for a quarterback? Fuck, just because he threw one touchdown? Seems like the kind of card that somebody would use in like the Madden Championship series or whatever. That one guy that never throws the ball and like played quarterback with his punter. And the set is done. I'm curious about this. Got two done. I just got to get any of these three done. And win a game. Or win a game. So if I win a game, then I just need to, you know, I don't have to get the tackles. Well, we'll do this one since we're one star away. Rushed for 35 yards and had three stiff arms.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach with you here today for another edition
of Madden Ultimate Team. Did John Madden really die?
Let's send it down to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis for the call.
Thank you, coach. We jump into this challenge in the third quarter with four
minutes
to go. We're still without a score, tied at zero. You have the ball on your own 20-yard line as we get set here, first and 10.
Ah, that's sad. One of the few Raiders that I respected. And it had nothing to do with the video game.
Set to begin this drive. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they?
The buzz kill to the night.
Similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 47 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it.
That's such a buzzkill. Like, can't even like get emotions going now.
He made the read, he was able to make the play. Well, there you have it.
Welcome, everybody. I'm the coach. Up next, another ultimate challenge on EA Sports. To finish this out, here's Brandon Godden. And Charles Davis.
Okay, coach, we will start this challenge off in the second quarter.
I just took the air out of everything.
You're down seven. You've got the ball on your own 25-yard line. And it's first and 10. Takes it up to the 40.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in the zone, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And he'll be taken down.
Like, they're way too quick on that flag.
Second down and goal. Mahomes, and they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. The defensive end, Daniil Hunter, drops it. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it prior to what would be an important fourth down. Can this defense hold him out? Here we go now, fourth and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Congratulations on yet another victory. Now you can go right to the next challenge if there's another one available, or return to challenges to receive.
Hello, and welcome into this Madden Ultimate Team Showdown. I'm your host, The Coach. Now let's hand it off to Brandon and Charles as we jump straight into the action.
We jump into this challenge for the good stuff in the fourth quarter.
I don't even know what to say anymore. Such a buzzkill.
You're ahead by a single point.
What's that?
Your opponent has the ball on their 20-yard line. First and 10. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Pass complete, Graham. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Now Dalton. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Mahomes down to a knee, and that should just about write a finish to this one.
And how about this finish? Able to take a knee, run out the clock, and close this game out by 1 point. You talk about how many coaches we talked to? They all said the same. All I want to do is win by 1 point. That got tested in this one.
Yep, and that cliche rings true. A single penny separates this one. All right, you did it. You got the win. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. You're watching Ultimate Challenges, and I'm your host, The Coach. Let's join this one already in progress. Here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We will start this challenge off in the second quarter with 4 minutes left on the clock. Still no points on the board. It's 0-0, but you're just across midfield as we get set here, first and 10. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 42 yards rushing for him now. Just 6 carries to this point. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team. Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Now a second down and 6. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You have to worry about the backside.
Damn, he stood me up.
You're running with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field. They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. And he will take it on in. Chiefs touchdown. taking it in from a yard out as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Nice job there getting the win. Next up, another challenge, of course.
I'm going to complete this one and back out and see where I'm at. I'm going to go take a breather.
Hello there. It's the coach with you here today. And this is an ultimate challenge. Taking you the rest of the way, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Brandon.
Okay, coach, we will start this challenge off in the second quarter with 4 minutes left on the clock. You're trailing by four. You've got the ball on your own 40. And it's first.
How's my control going?
He's going to float this over the middle deep.
Jeez, Randy.
And it's caught inside the 10. And oh, so close as he
Randy just went up and took that away.
To the 2 yard line. A big play there for KC.
He got mossed.
Take long one play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. To throw, it's Mahomes. And it's caught.
I was going through my progression. I never saw him, and I should have seen him out of the corner of my eye.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass as his guys have now moved out in front. Point after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good, and the lead is now 10-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick, and just shy of the 25. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact.
And the Chiefs are going to get him. Chris Jones in there to drop him for a 6 yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City. He'll send this up into the Nashville skyline, and it's a good one. Fielded at the 33. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in.
This was Tyreek Hill give somebody the uppercut.
He's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Mahomes firing complete. And all the way to
the 2-yard line. I tried diving for it. Was even close to the touchdown. What are you signaling? Working his way open down in the red zone, looked that one in, and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up. That's an Andy replay. Touchdown, Kansas City. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass, and the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. And just like that, another ultimate challenge has been defeated. Savor the victory, if only for a moment, because you know. Those are always nice to have because it's 350k. Six out of ten. This is five of the first eight. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I was wrong. No, there's one missing. Four, five, six, seven. Yeah, there's one missing. I don't get this. Like the other day when I had all of them completed and I still didn't get the daily coin pack, and then I randomly played later and then all of a sudden it popped up. I need 10 tackles. Just find one where we can just play defense.
Hey folks, it's the coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team.
John Madden just died. I don't think fantasy football is really anybody's concern right now.
set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over.
Nice catch.
Territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but he
up.
Trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this
one
game.
Tackle.
Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. On third down, it's Prescott. He rifles one and
hard to get tackles when you don't complete passes. Boom.
So just enough juice to get the three, and I think that wind at the back helped a little bit there.
Certainly did, and to me that tells
me Walker, he can make a 57 yarder just as long as he doesn't have COVID.
The wind was at his back. That's probably the outer limits of what he can make, and he knew the wind might be able to aid him and get that ball over the crossbar, and it did.
Possession of the football going back to the Cowboys. Following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about. Turnover.
Either run the ball or complete passes. You suck.
Maximizing opportunities.
Throwing again. Prescott on second and 10.
Okay, just keep throwing it to the other team. Maybe if I score 10 touchdowns, I can get 10 tackles on kickoffs.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He didn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. These may be an adventure this afternoon.
10 points, haven't snapped the ball once.
So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So an early 10-0 lead for him now. Looking into the Snowflakes and he mops him. Very short kick. This
what?
Will be
mop.
Taken by one of the up men.
This announcer's an idiot. Bring back John Madden.
Down in this ball game as they come up first and 10, and he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6, following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. They run here with Dowdle.
Stood him up at the line.
It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. They'll try and run.
Okay. We had to have a big hit to push him over the line of scrimmage. That's fantastic.
Pretty good shot there. They keep on the ground with Elliott.
Nice play.
Goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. They'll try to throw now. And this is going to be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Prescott from the gun on third.
Jeez, I just got owned at the line of scrimmage.
Steps away to his left.
How do you get run by Prescott?
Half. Sure, he falls under the category of mobile quarterback, but he's athletic enough that if you don't keep your rush lanes intact, he finds a way to hurt you.
As coaches like to say, I wouldn't call him a burner, but
yeah, that'll work.
Prescott, his third interception, picked up by Steven Nelson, and the Chiefs are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December, right? It is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just two. So Prescott to the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of five.
Second quarter.
10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. Second down and five. The give is to Elliott. Oh, Elliott gonna be hit. He coughs it up, loose football.
And it lands right on the line.
Cowboy was there to get it. He was, and Dallas will maintain possession. So they recover their own fumble. Now they face third and short. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there. And now fourth down. Anger is on the punt, and he gets this one away. And this returnable for Hill.
Oh, kicked out of your shoes.
You gotta love it, baby.
And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Just a fantastic punt return of 80 yards. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point through the Snowflakes. Up and good. And that makes our score 17-0. So his big play capability in full display there as he's able to return that punt for a touchdown. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. Oh, the return is Jordan Lewis, and he won't quite make it to the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. It hasn't gone particularly well for them. That's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field.
Oh, I whiffed on my tackle.
Short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Stress on your offense.
On the run, it's Dowdle. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third. Here's Brian Anger now. Remember, his first attempt was returned for a touchdown. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. Now Hill to return it. Oh, he nearly broke that one. As it stands, though, a heck of a 36-yard run back. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. On first down, Holmes. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Mahomes gonna throw. Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's gonna bring up a third down. A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. No, I have
to. Terrible runs.
First down as they're able to get the third down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
A gain of six there on first.
Oh, he burned him. That should be it. I need to go clear my head for a few minutes. Not that it was completely tragic, it's just a, I don't know, a buzzkill. I mean, he was 85. Still a legend.
I'll be back shortly.